to our Veterans Day program. We're glad you're here. Please stand for our pledges. Now we will pledge to the American flag. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now we will pledge to the Christian flag. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior whose kingdom it stands. One Savior crucified, risen and coming again with life and liberty to all who believe.
Now we will pledge to the Bible. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide God's words in my heart that I may not sin against God's heart.
You may be seated.
My grandfather is a veteran who fought in Vietnam. Even when I was little, he wanted me to honor and thank all the soldiers who served our country. This is for all the veterans. V is for valor, because veterans are brave. E is for every person who served our country. T is for time spent away from loved ones. E is for excellence in doing their jobs. R is for remembering those who died to keep us free. A is for America, the country and people they protected. N is for never giving up when times were hard. S is for sacrifices veterans made for all of us. Thank you, veterans and granddad.
Dear veterans, thank you for your service. Thank you for being brave while serving our country. I appreciate your willingness to protect us and our freedoms, especially the freedom to be a Christian without fear of persecution. I am also grateful for your family that made a sacrifice in order for you to serve. We salute you on this Veterans Day. God bless. McLean Liddy.
On Veterans Day, we honor all who answered to our special call. Soldier young and soldier old fought for freedom, brave and bold. And on, we are proud of all soldiers who thought about red, white, and blue. And although we may not know each name, we thank all veterans just the same.
This morning, we would like to honor veterans by performing the flag-holding ceremony. This flag will be proudly displayed in our glass case. acknowledgement to our country from the words of Stephen Decatur, our country in dealing with other countries may she always be right, but it is still our country, right or wrong.
The sixth fold is for where our hearts lie. It is with our heart that we pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The seventh fold is a tribute to our armed forces, for it is through the armed forces that we protect our country and our flag against all enemies.
The eighth fold is a tribute to the one who entered into the valley of the shadow of death that we might see the light of day and to honor our mother for whom it flies on Mother's Day.
The ninth fold is an honor to womanhood, for it has been through their faith, love, loyalty, and devotion that the character of the men and women who have made this country great have been molded.
The tenth fold is a tribute to Father, for he too has given his sons and daughters for the defense of our country since he or she was first born.
The 11th fold in the eyes of Hebrew citizens represents the lower portion of the seal of King David and King Solomon and glorifies in their eyes the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
The 12th fold is in the eyes of a Christian citizen represents an emblem of eternity and glorifies in their eyes God the Father, the Son, and Holy Ghost.
The last fold, when the flag is completely folded, the stars are uppermost, reminding us of our national motto, In God We Trust.
During our next song, we would ask veterans to stand when their branch of the military service song is played.
Dear veterans, today we want to thank you for your service to our country. We know that you missed a lot of major milestones in family and friends' lives. Here's a haiku I wrote to express my gratefulness and gratitude to you. Saved. Veterans so brave, fighting on the line to death, all of us you saved. Thank you for your service. Sincerely, Devin.
Dear veterans, thank you for your bravery and courage in serving our country. Thank you for your thank you for sacrificing so much so that we can have freedom in America today. I have so much respect for veterans because thanks to you, we have peace and justice forevermore. I cannot begin to imagine what you went through when fighting for our country's freedom, but I will be forever grateful for all that you've done for me and our country. So thank you so much and happy Veterans Day. Sincerely, Finley Howard.
Thank you, veterans, for fighting for our country. You have fought through pain to protect our freedom. You were courageous and strong during the tough battles that you fought. Your family sacrificed a lot to let you go and defend our country. Thank you for your service, thank you for serving our country. I appreciate your service. Joby.
Thank you.
last time so we can thank you all once together.
We appreciate all that you do, all for the red, white, and blue. Thank you for taking a stand. When you return, we shall all lend a hand. You are so brave and so strong. When I sleep at night, I know nothing will go wrong. Even though I'm just a 9-year-old kid, I understand the sacrifice you give, just as my papa did.
Thank you. still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that fight to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. There ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, just my children and my wife. Thank my lucky stars to be living here today. 'Cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, the men who died, who gave that fight.
say thank you. Thank you, veterans, for your sacrifice, for what you've done to serve. You know, as the verse said there at the end, greater love has no one than this, that he laid down his life for his friends. Right? That is exactly what Jesus Christ has done for us. He went to the cross on our behalf so that we don't have to. He is the ultimate veteran. And like him, following in his example, veterans, you have stepped out of your comfort zone. You have taken on the cross of others. You have borne our burdens to protect us and keep us safe. Thank you. Thank you for your service, for your sacrifice, for what you have done on behalf of each one of us in this room. You are a testimony, a biblical example for our students of what it means to truly serve and to sacrifice. Thank you. Our students wanted to say thank you as well in another way, and so we have put together one last short video where we would like to say thank you, and then I'll come back up and close us with a word of prayer. We do have a display that our students have put together of their artwork that together forms an American flag. We did that symbolically in the same way that our veterans work together to defend our country. We are one body, one community, one group. And so you are welcome to take pictures in front of that. We encourage you to do that. Enjoy some refreshments and stay for a few minutes. We are so glad that you have joined us this morning on this special day, Election Day. As well. How appropriate. So let me pray for us, and then we'll be dismissed. Let's pray. God, we give you the praise and the glory. God, thank you for what you have done. Thank you for sending your son, Jesus, the ultimate veteran, the sacrifice. Jesus, who was willing to go to the cross on our behalf, even when we did not deserve it. God, we are not deserving of the sacrifice of these veterans. We thank you for the commitment that they have made to serve you, to serve their communities, to serve their country. God, we thank you for the sacrifices that they have made on behalf of us. God, we trust this day to you, and we pray that you will help us to learn from their example to take the stories that they have to tell, to take the example that they have to share, to apply it to our lives so that we can go forward as an example of sacrifice and service to others. We trust this day to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great day.